नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। यू आर वॉचिंग स्मार्ट टेक विज। आई एम अंजलि, हियर विद द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ योर प्रॉब्लम। सो टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट द मोंगो एक्सपोर्ट कमांड दैट वी यूज फॉर एक्सपोर्टिंग सम डेटा फ्रॉम द मोंगो डेटाबेस। एदर यू हैव इंस्टॉल्ड इन योर लोकल सिस्टम और इन योर सर्वर, बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इम्पोर्ट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एक्सपोर्ट सम डेटा ड्यू टू सम बैकअप्स और ड्यू टू सम एनालिसिस, देयर सेवरल सिचुएशन वेयर यू वॉन्ट टू जस्ट एक्सपोर्ट द डेटा एंड कीप इट विद यू। So we will see that how we can export these data, these documents from the MongoDB, and we will see in different parts. And this is the part that how we will, what are the commands available, what are the keys available to ensure for the exporting the data, and then we will see for other type of commands in next part. So let's see what and how we can use the Mongo export query. Not a query, is just a command which we use to run it, not through the Mongo shell, but we will use it to run through our Mongo normal terminal that you have in your system. So let's go into it and let's get started. You can see this is my MongoDB which I installed on my local host, and it is currently, I configured it as a replica. It is not an issue if you are not on the replica. If you are on the normal MongoDB, it will work same as it is working here. Okay, so do not be confused with this. So this is my MongoDB. I am connected with my admin. Even I have the user for the Smarty Techie. I will show you later. So this is my Smarty Techie database, and these are the documents which I need to export from here to my local system. Okay, so how can I do this? So let's get see. You need, as I told earlier, that you do not need to run the command of Mongo export through the Mongo shell, and you need to go to your normal terminal. Okay, so after go to the terminal, this is the command which we use for the exporting. So let's see one by one what they all mean. This is the Mongo export. This is only the command which says that, okay, I want to export the data from the Mongo. And this is the host. Host means from where you want to get the data. I want to get the data from my local host system MongoDB. So there's one more thing, do not confuse. Either you can use the host full name host, or either you can use the H, okay, with single dash. So this will be both are the same. So you can see the documentation here. They are also given here, like see, verbose double dash and verbose, or either with a single V. Okay, so there will be multiple, you can use either with a double dash or with a single value. So that is all depends on you. So do not confuse with that. I am just using the whole key because I just wanted to let you what that all means, and it obviously their name explained themselves too. So that's why I'm showing all the names. So this is the host. This is my host, that is the local host, and it is on the 27017 port. It is a default port for the MongoDB. This is the username, and username which I'm using to connect is the Smarty Techie user, and the password for this is Smarty Techie 123. Okay. But if your MongoDB is not having authentication system on, then you please just skip that. Okay, just you need to do is just skip that. But I have a authentication system on my MongoDB, so that's why I need to keep it. Okay. Then again, password is this. If you are not giving the password, it will just prompt you to entering the password after entering this command. Okay, so if you are giving here, or either you need to give after the enter the command. Then again, next you need to do is you just need to provide the authentication database where which database this user will authenticate. So it will be the Smarty Techie where this user has been created. Now next is you have to show the DB. From which DB you want to get the data from which I want to know get is Smarty Techie. Now next is C means collection. You can either write the full collection key name, or either you can type it as a C. तो सी हेयर इज कलेक्शन एंड देन हेयर इट इज अ प्रोडक्ट, प्रोडक्ट इज द कलेक्शन नेम एज आई शो यू अर्लियर, दिस विल बी माई कलेक्शन, दैट इज द प्रोडक्ट्स, ओके. देन आफ्टर प्रोडक्ट इट यू नीड टू टेल which type of, in which type format you want the data to be transferred. Either with, it will transfer you in a two ways, either in a JSON format or either in a CSV format. If you will not give it like this, it will, its default value is JSON. It will automatically give you the data transferred as a JSON type. If you will provide any type, it will just give you the data as like given in the this command. Next is out. Out here is means where you want to transfer this data. I want to just either you will give you the just you need to give the path of the file which you want, where you want to save it. So my path will be the documents Anjali channel and test.txt. Okay, so this will be my command for transferring my data from my database, and collection name is product. So let's enter this. And okay, it is connected and then it exported the 12 records. Go to the documents channel and you can see that there is a test.txt. As I told you, it will transfer it in the JSON format by default because we haven't provided any type. And if I provide the type here, JSON, and just change the name it as test1.txt. It again exported test1.txt. So again you can see it just transferred the document in a JSON format. There is another one more type, that is the CSV format. We will see the CSV format in the next part if you want to see. Okay, so because CSV format needs some fields to just know that what are the fields you want to transfer. Okay, so that will be covered in the next part. Next, I want to tell you that it is, this command is transferring the whole document. You can use number of, you can see the documentation, there are number of commands given here, the keys that you can use to while exporting the Mongo. So we can use like, this is for the CSV, JSON. Like this, you can provide the read preference where you want the data to be read, that is the secondary or primary. So skip, limit, sort, query as well. So let's see how we can provide the query to the to our command. Okay, so we will provide the query as, let's say I want the data with the item equals to card, just a sample for you, the item, or you can see that quantity will be the 30. So let's see how we can provide the query. So we will provide the query as dash hyphen hyphen query, and this will be the query, like I said, the query will be quantity should be 30. And again change the name as like ABC, okay, and just enter this. Oh, I have mentioned the type as CSV. Let me just remove it. Okay, now it exported the data. This is not this one. Let's see what is the data we have. ABC.txt. So you can see it exported the data and it contains the 7 records. So this is how we can run the query and using the username, password, authentication database and out, and type we have covered is JSON. You can use the other options as well, like skip, limit, sort. There are number of options available. We will cover these options in the next part with the type CSV, because CSV is the most important part of the Mongo export, because most of them need the data in the CSV format, because we have a number of data in our collection. So we will see this in the next part. So till then, take care, bye bye.